Welcome back to my channel. Today in this video, I'm going to be talking about how to feed sulcata tortoises. This is a really important topic because correct diet is one of the most important ways to avoid metabolic bone disease. And that's an issue where in tortoises, their shell will start forming pyramids. That's something you really don't want to happen, and it only happens in captive tortoises. And I'll be talking about feeding these tortoises at different ages. So stick around and don't forget to subscribe to my channel. And you can also follow me over on TikTok and Instagram where you can see lots of more animal content. I want to give a quick shout out to the sponsor of this video, Zen Habitats. I've been working with Zen Habitats almost since they first started the business. They make amazing reptile cages that are large and aesthetically pleasing for your home, and well made for different types of reptiles. I love these cages, and I'm slowly moving all of my reptiles into these cages. They would make a good cage for a sulcata tortoise until it's ready to move outdoors. So please check them out at the link down below. Metabolic bone disease is a really big issue in captive tortoises, and that's where they start to develop pyramiding of the shell. It won't grow evenly, and I can put a few examples up of what this looks like. There are three main things involving diet that cause pyramiding. One of them is feeding vegetables that are too rich too often, and the other two are not feeding enough calcium and feeding too much calcium. Now, sulcatas are a vegetarian species, so they don't have insects or small animals in their diet. They will eat mainly a plant-based diet. The first thing to understand is that they should be eating mainly dry vegetation, not rich vegetables like broccoli, lettuce, or other common grocery store veggies. They still need those types of veggies, but it's going to make up about 20% of the diet. The rest of the time, they should be eating other types of plants, like weeds and grasses that aren't commonly found in the grocery store. This can be really hard for those that don't have direct access to plants like this. You can buy grass hay for your tortoise or try growing food for them yourself. It can also be difficult to get your baby tortoise to accept this type of diet. Tortoises will, of course, always go for veggies over grass and wheats, but just because that's what they like does not mean that that's what's healthy for them. Overfeeding veggies can make their shell grow unevenly and give them digestive issues. One of the easiest things to get them to eat, for those picky ones that want their vegetables, is mustard weed. This is a little bit of a softer weed that is good for them and will help with a transition in diet. It's easy for babies to eat and great for picky adults. So the main part of their diet should be weeds and grasses. You can pull up weeds from your yard and give them to your tortoise if they're safe to eat. I'm going to include a list of plants for tortoises that you can find commonly growing around in your area. That way you can find food to provide to your tortoise. You can really make sure your tortoise is healthy by providing them a wide variety of food. I collect food for my tortoise by looking for plants that grow around the farm. And I also wanted to mention that if you do like the clothing I'm wearing in this video, be sure to check the description for a link to these unique prints. I've been getting a lot of questions about my animal print dresses. Some important things to keep in mind is to avoid any plants that have been treated with chemicals, of course. Roundup will kill your tortoise, and you want to check that the area has not had any artificial fertilizers. Make sure the food you provide has been able to grow in a safe and natural environment.
And let's talk about how tortoises eat dog poop. Now, I know this isn't something that is commonly talked about, but animal feces is actually a very normal part of a tortoise's diet. In the wild, tortoises would eat wolf poop, coyote poop, and other types of animal feces, and it's a good source of protein and calcium for them.
The animal, whether it be a wolf or a dog, has already digested the food and broken down the calcium in the bones, and it didn't absorb 100% of it, so the poop can still be rich in nutrition. So if you catch your tortoise eating your dog poop, this is pretty normal. Should you be worried? Well, that really depends on how you care for your dogs. If your dogs are being treated for worms, such as heartworms, or given medications or anything extra, you should make sure your tortoise does not eat their poop. It can be really harmful to them. Oral tick medication, pain relief medication, and even certain ingredients in dog kibble can be harmful to your tortoise.
But if your dogs are on a raw, natural diet with no medications, it's actually perfectly fine for your tortoise to eat their poop. I just bet you weren't expecting that tidbit of information when you clicked here. Next, I'll tell you about some of my favorite veggies to feed my tortoise. First up, I love providing all types of chili peppers. Reptiles and birds do not have the same taste receptors that us mammals do, and cannot taste spice. This is an evolutionary adaptation because reptiles can do a wonderful job of spreading chili plants. So since you don't have to worry about peppers being spicy for your tortoise, it's an amazing thing to add to their diet because they're so rich in nutrients. Another thing I like to provide is cactus or nopal. This is really great for those tortoises that are very picky and don't want to eat drier vegetation. If you need to feed tortoises a veggie a little bit more often, I recommend going with nopal. They do also enjoy aloe vera plants as well. The types of fruit that I like to provide for them are cactus, pear, and dragon fruit, because they can actually eat the entire thing, including the skin. Now for calcium, I recommend getting a high quality powder calcium for babies and sprinkling it on their food once or twice a week, depending on how high in calcium the food you're feeding is. So take into consideration how much calcium is naturally in the vegetables that you're offering. For adults, you can give them the option of getting more calcium by providing a cuttle bone. If your tortoise is eating dog poop occasionally, he might not want or need the cuttle bone.
Most important thing is to tailor the diet to your individual tortoise. And that means monitoring their activity and their growth in order to make sure that the diet that you're providing is the most suitable for your individual tortoise. And here's a reminder that tortoises do need heat in order to digest their food. So if your tortoise is inside during the winter months, you will need to provide them with a heat source. Otherwise, they can go off their food for several months. And of course, if you have an indoor tortoise still, or if they're in a terrarium or something like that, of course they do need to be provided with that heat source in order to digest their food on a regular basis. Tortoises will eat random things like plastic and bags and just anything that they can swallow. So you do have to be careful to make sure that they don't have access to anything like that. It can impact their stomach, and the impaction can lead to death. Thanks so much for watching, guys. I hope this helped you with your tortoise. Be sure to leave a comment down below, and I will see you guys in the next video. Bye!